Hey, Mando.
What is it?
He wants to ask you a question about Christmas.
What's Christmas?
Oh, sorry. Life Day.
Oh, Life Day. That's a great day. That's my favorite day. My favorite day of life.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Actually, that's not the question I was going to ask you. I was going to ask you, you ever drive yourself crazy at the end of the year with all these kinds of things you got to do?
Yeah, I've done that before.
Well, you got to have a plan.
Listen, Batwoman, you always have a plan for everything. You have a plan? You're a woman with a plan. You've always got a plan. I'm kind of jealous.
Well, you know, just use your head.
Do you mean my helmet?
Yeah.
Hey, guys.
What is it?
I think Aristotle figured out a new way to do my voice. Cool. Okay, great. Hey, Asagi Taco.
Dude, it's a Ahsoka Tano. What's wrong with you, man? What's wrong with you?
Sorry. Sorry about that. Tell us about what we're doing today.
All right, you guys ever see that movie Die Hard?
Of course, everybody's seen that movie.
Yeah. No, I'm talking about the sequels. You ever see the sequels to Die Hard?
Of course, I've seen all of the Die Hards, every Die Hard.
Yeah. Well, how come that guy never died? Yeah, it's not like he's Batwoman or anything. I mean, I could survive. I've been made to survive. I've got a plan.
You've always got a plan.
Yeah, she's always got a plan. You know who doesn't have a plan?
Who's that?
You're looking at him. You ever go crazy? This is the worst time of year to be in parking lots, if you ask me. We were just hanging out here waiting for people to show up, but if you're just showing up for the first time right here now, right now, there's a giveaway. There's gonna be a giveaway.
Tell them about it, Mayfeld.
It's Mayfeld. Yeah. You guys like PlayStations? You like a PlayStation 5? Gonna give away a PlayStation 5. Gotta subscribe, though. Make sure you subscribe for that PlayStation 5.
How are they gonna win it?
Well, first, they have to subscribe, like, share, and comment. That's it. That qualifies you to win. But, you know, the more comments you make, the more qualified you is.
What?
I mean, the more qualified you are.
We're having a day, aren't we?
Yeah, it's almost Christmas. I mean, sorry, for you guys, it's Life Day.
Life Day. Oh, such a headache.
I would like to... Hey, Ismael. Hey, Wesley.
What, you want to shoot Bill Burr?
Hey, why would you want to shoot me? I'm a nice guy. I took down that admiral. Remember that? You know, of course I'm also a bad guy. He set me free.
Yeah.
But, hey, you're going to want to avoid parking lots at the Target. You're going to want to avoid parking lots at Walmart. You're going to want to avoid Walmart altogether.
What's Walmart?
It's like a super shopping center.
Oh, you mean like Fenaric Jargon Darkin Storkin.
Yeah, whatever you guys call it here out in space.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I avoid that at all costs. In my whole life, I've avoided going to Target. You don't want to go to Walmart. They don't even pay their employees. Hey, Soggy Taco, how come you're not saying anything? Aristotle hasn't assigned a button for me yet and keeps forgetting, so... All right, I understand. Hey, guys, thank God you're here, because we're going to have a fun show today. We're going to play Among Us. We're going to talk about the Die Hard sequels. We're going to talk about all that kind of fun stuff. So buckle up, sit back, relax. Yeah, don't relax. You can be uptight if you want. You know, do whatever it takes. Do some bench presses. Ismael Kuya, do like a sit-up. Do like a punch up. Do some shadow boxing, maybe. I don't know. Get all riled up. Get ready to fight.
What's the point of all this?
Just saying. You know, sometimes when we play games here, we play interactive games with the fans. It gets riled up. It gets fun. We've opened up the voice channel on the Discord, so now you can directly talk to Aristotle Full Throttle while you're playing him.
Sounds like a hoot. You know what? Who wants this Darksaber? I got this extra Darksaber hanging around. I'll take it. Here you go. Oh, here you go. All right. Let's get started. Shall we start the show? Are there enough people here to hang out, to have fun? Pushing buttons. Pressing buttons. Pressing all the buttons. Sounds like Mitch McConnell. Sounds like Mitch McConnell's here. I look like Mitch McConnell under this mask. I also drag my feet up passing bills in the Senate. Just Mitch McConnell. You know, Mitch McConnell and Buffalo Bill are the same person. Mitch McConnell. Mitch McConnell.
The hell are you doing?
Hey, everybody. I don't know what's going on over here. I'm just hanging out, having a good time. Oh, my voice sounds like it's echoey. What's up? I'm Aristotle Full Throttle. Hey, guys. We're going to have some fun today. First of all, we're going to talk about Die Hard. Why is Die Hard excellent, but the sequels, you know, like, meh? You know, the sequels are meh. I would characterize the sequels of To Die Hard as meh. I didn't get the whole word in here. Let me affix this. There we go. Try Hard with a Vengeance. That's... Guys, every day I put the title of the show, what we're doing, what we're talking about, right down at the bottom, and it's not always 100% accurate. What are you guys doing for Christmas? What'd you get? What did you ask for? What did you ask Santa Claus for? Tomorrow, by the way, tomorrow is the Aristotle Full Throttle Holiday Special. The Christmas Holiday Special premiere. It's going to premiere tomorrow. There's going to be a premiere. I'm still working on it. I'm still editing it. I'm still finishing it up. I still have a ways to go. But I'm going to stay up all night and I'm going to finish editing it. And hopefully it'll be dumb enough for all of us to enjoy slightly, which is the goal. Guys, if you're joining us on Instagram, yeah, it's going to be fun. See, I get into these projects minds. Jen will tell you. Let me just zoom out here. Jen will tell you, I'm like in the zone now. I'm editing this thing and I keep getting more and more ideas and I'm like, I can't stop myself. So I'm trying to rush through it. So it's going to be like goofy enough, but also rushed, but also like, it's going to look like you spent way too much time on a thing that looks rushed. If that makes any sense. My request to Santa Claus was for him to be real. Well, you're going to find out about that tomorrow. You just watch the holiday special and you'll find out all about that. Or will he? Dramatic chord. I couldn't get it in time. It's going to be fun. It's going to be silly. It's going to be dumb. And we'll see. We'll see what happens. What do you think, Grogu? Do you think I should sprinkle some Grogu on your head so that you get some hairs? He's got some hairs on his head, though. But not a... This one's bald. So I'm talking about the Die Hard movies today. Why are the Die Hard sequels not as good as the first one? First, actually, I want to tell you about my saga about ordering a new phone. Because this is the fun part. The first part of the show is a little anecdote of my life and how weird it is. It's not that weird. It's the end of the year. It's Christmas time. We're all running around doing last-minute things. There's so much on our plate. But we get that moment to relax on Christmas Day, hopefully. You'll get that moment as well. I'm going to watch Wonder Woman on Christmas Day, relax, watch some behind the scenes of The Mandalorian Season 2. I know that they're releasing those both on HBO Max and Disney Plus, respectively. So if you guys are watching that, I might pop onto the Discord and drop some comments in there. But in the meantime, I'm trying to get it all done before then. I'm trying to get all done so I can relax for Christmas. On Christmas Eve here on Aristotle Full Throttle, we'll have like a little mini hangout. It'd be nice to relaxed time if you want to join me. Maybe I'll just play the drums. Christmas, the drummer boy. I'll just play the drummer boy. That's the worst song. I hate that song. Except when Bing Crosby and David Bowie sing it. It's the only time it's good, but they still didn't sing it the right way. They jazzed it up. They're like, peace on earth, let it be. You know, they added more to it to make it more special because the song itself is dumb. There's that. That song is dumb. You know what we should do today? Maybe instead of Die Hard or in addition to Die Hard? The worst Christmas songs. The worst Christmas song categorically is the Paul McCartney song. Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. That song makes me want to like... It makes me want to take a nail clipper to my eyelashes. Whatever that means. So let me tell you about this phone situation. I'm ordering this phone. I got the... So 2 months ago, this new phone becomes available. And I says to myself inside my head, I would like to have this phone. So what I did is I called my phone company. Well, actually, I just ordered it on my line. I logged into Verizon Wireless. I will call them out by name because I'm having a fun time going back and forth with them on Twitter. Here's a hint, guys. If you ever have a problem with a major corporation that's giving you like the biggest headache in the world, publicly mention it. Because they are like, oh no, damage control. We don't want bad PR. We'll treat you horribly in private so long as you don't complain. But if you complain publicly to the populace, to the general populace about the problems that we are causing you, we will jump right on it. So if that's a pro tip from Aristotle Full Throttle, your bro with the fro in the know. So I suggest if you ever have an ongoing major issue, just air your grievance to your friends and family publicly on a social media, and they will do damage control quickly. They will actually take care of the problem way faster than they would any other way. Because I spent probably 4 hours on the phone with them in the last 2 months. I have spent time online trying to they send me direct links to order this phone, and I would order the phone. So 2 months ago, I ordered the phone through the app. As soon as the phone became available, I clicked on it, I checked out, I got an email. Thank you for your order. Here is your order confirmation number. Here is your store number. Here is the transaction number. Thank you. Your order is processing. So then I check back a week later and it still says processing. So I'm like, okay, well maybe that's, you know, because the phone's not out yet. And then I checked back 2 weeks after that, it still said processing. So I call them. I call Verizon Wireless and I say, hello, Verizon Wireless. Why does it say I was processing? And I log into my account. Here is the order number. Here is the confirmation number. I'm staring at the screen. I can send you a screenshot. And they were like, give us the number. Oh, yeah, that order doesn't exist. And I'm like, I'm looking right at it. I confirmed it with you. They're like, oh, no, yeah, that don't exist. That's not an order. I'm like, here's the order confirmation. What do I have to do? This has never been this hard. Every time I've ordered a phone, I've pressed like 3 buttons, and then the phone came to me magically like within a week. So then, I go through this process with them a month ago. Again, I'm like, it says processing. They're like, okay, well, the best thing to do right now is to cancel it all out and reorder the phone. And we did this, and it took 2 hours on the phone to do this. I don't know why. And they're like, well, it's on back order. It'll be here in 3 weeks. So I'm like, fine. So I check back on the date it says it's supposed to be shipping, and it says processing. I went through their direct link. I went through the agent. I went through their process, and then it says processing. I hope Verizon is watching. I hope you're watching. Uh-oh, I forgot to update the titles on Restream. It's going to say that we're talking about The Mandalorian. That's fine. I've been busy. So now I'm trying to get in touch with them, and they're like, oh, yeah, that order doesn't exist. And I'm like, how does it not exist? I went through your company. I went through you directly. And they're like, well, the best thing we could do is cancel it and reorder it. I'm like, no, I'm not doing that. I'm going to publicly announce this over to Twitter. Okay, thank you for changing it. I just think, thank you, Jen. That's why Jen is the producer of the show. She's got the back of the show. So now I'm just like livid. I'm like, guys, I would like my phone. So then they send, I tweeted out yesterday, and then they send me a message. Oh, well, follow us, Verizon Wireless support on Twitter is like, well, we'll send you a direct link. So I click on the direct link this afternoon. They were like, would you like us to waive the upgrade fee and send it to you overnight? And I was like, yes. And they were like, just click this link. So I click the link. The first four times I clicked the links, it said, oop, sorry, there's no page here. The fifth time I clicked the link, it opened up a chat room. And I was like, hello, hello, hello. And then I'm going back and forth to them on Twitter as well in the DMs. And I'm like, hey, guys, I am clicking on the link and there's nobody there. And you're not even here. And they're like, oh, yeah, just let us know. And I'm like, okay. And then finally they get back to me. And they're like, what's your first and last name on the chat? And that's the last I ever heard from them. And that was 2 hours ago. So that is my holiday headache. I'm sure we all have a holiday headache. But it's all going to be good. It's all going to be chill on the day. We're all going to calm down and relax. I might even eat a cookie or a sandwich. Or a sandwich cookie. You ever make a, one time, at the beginning of the pandemic, I ordered three packages of Oreos. One was Blondie Oreos, one was Double Stuff, and one was regular Oreos. And I made every permutation of Oreo sandwich that you can make with those. I sure did. And I ate those Oreos. I ate all of the Oreos. I probably ate every single one of those Oreos. Maybe I gave Grogu half an Oreo. But I do like cookies. What's your favorite cookie? Let us know. So that's my drama for today. I'm going to try to let it roll off my back. I just think it's kind of ridiculous that Verizon Wireless, billion-dollar company, doesn't understand how... I literally tweeted at them just about 20 minutes ago. I was like, why can't you do this? Do you guys not like money? I'm literally trying to give you money and you're doing everything in your power to stop taking my money. I think it's hilarious. Oh, boy. But other than that, I'm neck deep in an edit, which is going to be fun, and it's for the fans. It's to show my appreciation for everybody who's been watching. And if you've been watching the show, hopefully you get the jokes. The jokes are very inside jokes. They're very Aristotle Full Throttle jokes. They're for you and you alone. A select audience. It's what they say, esoteric. My name is Esoteric Eric. Well, guys, are you excited to play, it just fixes Twitch. Oh, that's okay. I can go back over the other ones and just do that, except for the one on Twitter. The one on Twitter is going to say Mandalorian, but that's fine. Once people get here, they're going to be like, Die Hard? What are we talking about, Die Hard? How ridiculous is that story about the phone? I think, I'm just like... I don't understand, guys. Two times I ordered through you, through a direct link, and I ordered it, and you were like, sorry, we don't take money. We're completely inept, even though we make billions of dollars. But I'm almost like, well, I might as well wait for the next phone. It's already been out for 2 months. So I might just do that. But I need the phone. I need the phone for... all of these things. Grogu, what should we do now? Let's see. Let's check in. Hey, everybody. This is the Carl Weathers Predator Weathers Report featuring the Action Jackson AccuPredator Weathers Forecast Radar. And Cardi B, also the Predator. Did you guys... Hey, Jeb. Hey, Raccoon Raiders. Hey, Wesley Plotkey. What are you getting for Christmas? Me? I hope to get world peace. Cardi, tell them what's in the forecast.
Looks like we're gonna get some world peace. Gonna get some world peace. Oh, and a predator. Ah!
Well, there you have it. World peace and a predator. This has been a Carl Weathers Predator Weathers Report featuring the Action Jackson AccuPredator Weathers radar forecast with a chance of chance o' showers. And Cardi B. Yeah. I think it's just, I get all high strung. We're down to the wire. We're down to the last couple minutes before Christmas. And I wanna do something very special. And I don't wanna mess it up. I'm like, Christmas has to be perfect for everyone. Or else I ruined Christmas. Hopefully I won't ruin Christmas for you guys. Alright, well, we're gonna play Among Us. But first, I'm gonna ridicule the Die Hard sequels. Not too badly. The second one was not that good. It's directed by Rennie Harlan. He's not a very good director. It's got the same kind of cinematography, the same type of music as the first one, but it's just not as good. The third movie is pretty good. It's actually John McTiernan, the director of the original Die Hard, came back to direct Die Hard with a Vengeance, I think it was, the third one. And it kind of brings the DNA, literally, from the original back into it. Because, again, Simon is the bad guy. And who is Simon? None other than. Well, you got time. You got about 10 minutes. This Simon is none other than Hans Gruber's brother. Simon Gruber. Grogu Gruber. Grogu gonna be the next bad guy in the next Die Hard. Grogu Gruber. Grubby Grogu Gruber. That's hard to say. Don't try even say that. But I liked that one second best, but only about one third as much as the first one. I didn't mind Live Free or Die Hard. I just didn't think it was great. I just didn't think it was this great movie. Live Free or Die Hard. I never saw the last Die Hard movie. A Good Day to Die Hard. I never seen it, and I never will. I never will watch it. Do you know why I will never watch it? Because not only does it have Jack Worthington, Sam Courtney. What's his name? Jai Courtney Worthington. He's in that. But I don't care none too much for that guy. That's all. Also, I just don't think... It looks terrible because it became a caricature. And here's why. Here's what happened with the Die Hard movies. The first one is distinctly a Christmas movie. Not only is it a Christmas movie, but it's a guy reconciling with his wife, a guy forming a new friendship with a cop, a guy beating these, what he thinks are terrorists, but they're bank robbers. It's a really awesome bad guy in the first one. You just go down the list of reasons why it's good. And those are the very reasons why the sequels are not good, because it was so important for Reginald Vell Johnson, the guy on the ground, the cop, the flat-footed cop who likes the Twinkies, that dude was the heart and soul of the first Die Hard. The relationship between John McClane and the guy, we're seeing what kind of guy John McClane is through the eyes of his ex-wife, or his current wife, who is separated, and this new friendship that he's forming, and also the fact how much he loves his wife because he's trying to fight all these bad guys, and also how much he loves being a cop. All of these things are really important to the DNA of the movie. Hey, Pegster 1994, we're talking about the Die Hard movies and why the first Die Hard movie is excellent. And then the rest are just like, okay, well, you know, it seemed like a tough kind of thing. Die Hard was the first movie where you had a guy who literally died hard. It was difficult to kill this guy, and that was the hook of the movie. And before that, movies weren't really like that. Since then, every movie has been like that. Every movie, action movie that is, has someone, guy or girl, who gets beaten up but doesn't seem to die. And it was such a novel premise for the first one. It was a novel premise to use someone who was kind of known for being not an action hero to become an action hero. There's a great documentary on this on I think it's The Movies That Made Us on Netflix. There's also, they do one on Ghostbusters and Home Alone and all of these fun things, and you can get all those facts and stuff on it. Yeah, it's such a great movie. It gets me into the Christmas mood every year. I know that if you start Die Hard at like 10
02 or something on New Year's Eve, Hans falls off the building at midnight. I forget how you do it. Die Hard, what a great movie. But the sequels suffer from a lack of that character building stuff that we needed in the first Die Hard to actually care about this guy who was in such a sticky situation. Also, the bad guy. Your good guy's only as good as the bad guy, and the bad guy's only as good as the good guy. So you needed a bad guy like Hans Gruber to seem like incredibly threatening, even though he looked sophisticated. With his beard. There's a great shot in Die Hard when they first come off the truck, the bad guys, the terrorists, Hans and his gang, and they're walking out of the back of the truck. The truck, the gate comes up, they all start walking out, and it's a great shot. We're coming back, following them back, and they walk through a doorway, but there's one guy, yeah, he knows about what I'm talking about. There's one guy on the side who walks right into the wall. It's really funny. I wish I could find that. Maybe I could find that for us, and we'll watch that clip, and then we'll laugh about it, and then we'll play Among Us. Do you guys like Among Us? Yeah, Die Hard, everybody loved that movie. It's such a great movie. I got to see Die Hard in the movie theater at the, I think it's the Millennium Theater, downtown Los Angeles, about 6-7 years ago. That was the first time I saw it on the big screen, and I saw it with a crowd about a week before Christmas, and it was one of the best movie experiences I've ever had, because the whole audience was just quoting everything that was happening. When Hans walks into the frame, it's just everybody just starts cheering, because they cheer for the bad guy in that movie because he's such a good bad guy. Hans Die Hard reveal. When they come out of that truck, I'm going to show you this. It's hilarious. Let me see if I can do this. Google Hans Truck Die Hard. Do you know what I'm talking about, Malin? When Die Hard with a Vengeance. I was just talking about how that borrows a lot of the DNA from the first Die Hard. Literally. So it's interesting. Because John McTiernan comes back to direct that one. And also, Simon is Hans' brother. How was your first time watching Die Hard like? Well, Wesley Plotkey, the first time I watched Die Hard was with your dad. It was on VHS. That's how young we are. So we were watching Die Hard. We rented it, or somebody rented it. I forgot who rented it. But we watched the first 45 minutes, and we could not stop watching. It was like the middle of the day in the summer or something. Even though it's a Christmas movie. I don't know. I forget. But we put it in the VCR. Is what it was called back then. There was no button to press to stream things. It was just, you had to watch actual video cassettes and rewind them. Rewinding is not even a thing anymore. So we put the video in and we were like, could not look away. It was just so instantly, I want to watch this movie. And then my brother and his friend came home and, they were like, what you watching? And we're like, Die Hard. And they're like, oh, is that the one with the guy who's from TV? Because Bruce Willis was known for being a TV actor at that point, and nobody really took him seriously. They were like, oh, that guy, he's kind of a snarky TV guy. And we're like, yeah, but it's really good. And they were like, oh, yeah, you want to rewind it? So we rewound it. We sat there for 5 minutes, rewinding the, the VHS tape to the beginning. And we watched it. Yes, it was Moonlighting, Malin. That's right. That was the TV show he's on with Sybil Shepherd. But we rewound it to the beginning. And let me tell you, the first time we watched it, we were just, you know, it's such an engaging movie that your heart is racing. You're like, oh my God, how is he going to get out of this? How is he going to get out of this? And then the roof of the building explodes. And we were just like, this is insane. This is insane. What an insane movie. And there's some good laughs in that movie. And, by the time you get halfway through the movie, three quarters of the way through the movie, you're just cheering this guy on. You're like, you can't have this guy die. For some reason, we still have suspense, but even though this guy is literally gonna die hard. This man Aristotle ain't slime for real. He don't even be in the hood. I don't even know what you're saying. Let's see. Die Hard 3 was one of my favorite NYC movies. Yeah, it's a great opening for Die Hard 3. They said in Die Hard 3, they had that Summertime in the City song and then an explosion. It was a great way to start a movie. John McTiernan is probably one of the best action directors ever. He directed Predator. Dude did Predator. You know what I'm talking about?
I know exactly what you're talking about. I was in Predator. You might remember me. You might remember, if I put one arm behind my back, you might recognize me, actually. I got my arm shot off by the Predator. The Predator done shot my arm, and he stuck me through. But, you know, I survived, and then I was in Happy Gilmore, and I only had one hand in Happy Gilmore. Remember that? Oh, there's a Predator in the forecast. Watch out.
He don't even be in the...
I totally agree with you, Zooted Squidward. He don't even be in the hood at all. there's no hood. There's no hat. There's nothing. But if you want a hoodie, you could probably go to the Teespring and get a hoodie.
Here's the main feed. Look, that's me and my man Bruce Willie. That's Bruce Willie right there. This is like super zoomed in on my face. I gotta... East Hollywood is kind of like the hood, I guess. Yeah, I live in the hood. East Hollywood is totally the hood. Yeah, the Mandalorian. How do you not like the Mandalorian? You probably came here because the title says Mandalorian. I messed that up. I was supposed to type in Die Hard, but I was too busy cooking up a surprise for tomorrow. It's not much of a surprise. I've already mentioned it. It's going to be the holiday special. The Aristotle holiday special. It's going to be special for sure. Mostly stupid. But it's for inside jokes for everybody. Yeah, Baby Yoda goes hard. Watch out, because Baby Yoda going to get turnt. Okay? On Christmas Eve. Watch it. He going to be eating some frog eggs. And... you don't even want to see him on 15 frog eggs. Dude's going to be passed out. He's going to be force choking. He'll be force choking the elf on a shelf. You know what I'm saying? What did you think of the finale? We can talk about that. Looking forward to watching Jingle All the Way. Come on. Jingle All the Way.
Where's the button? Where the button at? I gotta squint.
I have too many things. Uh-oh. Why is he so tiny? Oh, I know why.
Yeah, Jingle All the Way is the best Christmas movie. That's the one I'm in.
No, Mr. Freeze, you're in Batman and Robin.
Yeah, whatever, but I'm also in Jingle All the Way. Remember that one where I wear the jetpack and I'm like Mr. Action Dude? Remember The Last Action Hero? Remember that series of movies that I tried to do that also appealed to a younger generation? It was like Kindergarten Cop, but it was also rated R or PG-13. And then there was like Last Action Hero, and then Sinbad was in there. Yeah, Sinbad was in Jingle All the Way with me. You know, Aristotle, why don't you tell them the story about the time you went to the diner and you saw Sinbad?
Just last year, I was eating at an outdoor, maybe a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, I was eating at an outdoor restaurant, and at the next table was Sinbad. And I was like, that's Sinbad. He from Jingle All the Way. What else was he in? He was on another show. Was he on 227? I don't remember. But, yeah, Twins. He was also in Twins. And he was also in Junior. He was like, I got it. I'm a comedian. I saw Sinbad sitting at the table next to me, and Sinbad was making everybody laugh at his table. Not only, see, this dude, Sinbad, I find him hilarious. I think he's a very funny guy. I think he cannot help but be funny. He's got like an energy that is just a funny energy. Just like so not only was he making the table that he was sitting at laugh, but the tables around him started to laugh because he was just so funny and engaging. He's just a energetic guy. It was great, great, honestly, and The Cool Mandalorian is better than the three Star Wars trilogy movies. Zooted Squidward, you nailed it right on the head. That is absolutely true. I would say that the feeling I got, Malin, I don't know if you saw the latest Mandalorian. We're kind of jumping all over the map here, but if you saw the latest Mandalorian, the feeling I got at the end of the season finale of season 2 was a bigger feeling, emotional feeling, than I felt in all three of the sequel trilogy movies. There were a couple moments in The Phantom Menace. In The Phantom Menace, I felt it, my heart skip a beat, maybe when we first saw Luke. I was like, oh, cool. That was at the very end of The Force Awakens. And then The Last Jedi, when Luke died. Spoiler alert, when Luke fades away into the sunset, I was like, oh, man. But I did like that feeling of seeing Luke, like, meditating, and he projected himself across the universe. Haven't seen it, but saw. Seesaw. Yeah, Malin, it's a great moment. I don't know if you've seen any of the Mandalorians, but if you build, it's really one of those moments that's earned. It took 2 seasons, and it slowly built into it, and it almost felt like a curveball. But at the end of the day, you're like, no, this is what has to happen. it was well played, Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni. Well played. You guys, I was like, they're not doing this, are they? Oh, yeah, they are. Well, obviously, they got to do this. This makes perfect sense. So it was great. It's great. That, I think, is going to be the goal, I think, of the TV shows on Disney Plus regarding Star Wars for the next couple years, the next indefinite amount of years, is going to be, all right, let's return of the Jedi. This is going to return to being Jedis. All right, guys, everybody got their Among Us downloaded, because we'll have a private lobby that you can join on the Discord. Malin, if you want to jump over to YouTube, or if you want to jump over to Twitch and continue watching the feed, that's where we'll be, because I got to use my phone. I got to use my phone to play Among Us with everybody. So the code for the Among Us lobby will be in the Discord gaming channel. So if you guys want to go there, if you're on the Discord, if you want to join the Discord, that's the live voice channel. The voice channel is open, so if you want to yell at each other and say silly things at each other, and you want to talk to Baby Grogu, you could go ahead and do that. If you want to join the game, you could go on Discord. If you want to join the Discord, remember, subscribe on Twitch or pledge at least $1 a month on Patreon. That way, you get exclusive access to the Discord and you can play along. If you want to qualify to win that PS5, all you need to do is subscribe. Subscribe to Twitch, subscribe to YouTube, follow on Instagram. So, all right, guys. I gotta find the... All right, so we've got the stream code. Let's see. Well, on Instagram, hang out with us on Twitch, and I will see you over there. So I'm going to end the feed on Instagram, and we're going to start to game. We're going to proceed to gaming. Malin, come on the show. Come on the show next week. Come hang out, and we'll talk about it. All right, see you guys later on Instagram. I gotta share the video. This is always the fun part, guys. You gotta share the video. What do I do here? What's the button I press? Share? I gotta get my bifocals and get them all lined back up. I don't even understand what's the button. All right. But Die Hard is a Christmas movie, guys. It is the best Christmas movie, arguably. Besides... I don't know. We already did best Christmas movies like a month ago. And we decided it was Die Hard because there's no other right answer. All right. This is the fun part. I have to say all of the hashtags. Do you guys have Among Us downloaded? Because we can play. All right. I'm going to put this on the AFT Live. Let's see. Hashtag Die Hard. Hashtag Christmas. Hashtag Christmas movies. Hashtag movies 2020. Hashtag movies. Hashtag Star Wars, hashtag The Mandalorian. We talked about all of those things. Let's see. Also, I didn't see the trailer for Coming to America yet. So should I watch that, or is it rated R?
I actually haven't seen it either.
I want to watch it. Should I watch it now? Should we watch it together?
Sure.
All right. Let's see. I think I was also going to find that moment of Hans Gruber walking into the door into the doorway. It's pretty hilarious. Let's see. All right. Hans Gruber truck entrance. This is such a funny clip. If I can... Let's see. Comes out of the truck. I'm just thinking out loud. Well, I don't know if I could find it anywhere. When I find it, I will show you. Let's watch the trailer for Coming to America. If it's not rated G, I might have to stop watching it. But it's also, it's coming to the number 2 America. Let's see. All right. Coming to America. I don't know if I'll get, like, demonetized for this, but whatever. Que sera, sera. Right? Let's all watch this Amazon Prime. Oh, is it on Amazon Prime? Wait, was that Darth Vader? Time out.
You must heed my words before I'm gone, my son.
That sounds like Darth Vader to me.
Now, you will be king.
King of Zamunda.
But the throne must pass to a male heir. Hakim, it appears...
That's Mufasa.
A son who must be found.
Prepare the royal jet.
We are going back to America. Oh, hell no, your majesty. Come
on. I like our city hall. Say it again. Leslie Jones! I love Leslie Jones. Oh, she's back too. Wesley Snipes.
I'm the king of this shop.
How old?
Well.
How?
Three babies with the flies on the face. Hey, oh, that's too much. Now, you stepped over the line. Now, we won't be talking that kind of shit about the hungry babies. You're going to have to get out of my chair.
Politically incorrect.
So what are you doing back here, Hotel Rwanda?
All right.
I'm back. Say it again.
That's on Prime. All right. Well, I'll be able to watch that. I gotta say, I don't know. It's hard to tell. Now here we are. We're at the gaming console. And let's open up Among Us. There's a humongous fungus Among Us. Jen, do you have a lobby code that we can all join?
I can start one.
Okay, thank you.
Do you want to try a new map, or do you want one we've already done?
Let's try a new map. I think that would be fun.
All right. I will put it in the Discord. Do you want it in the main channel or the gaming channel?
Let's put it in the gaming channel, please.
Okay.
Thank you. So, all right. Online. Enter code. All right.
It's in the Discord.
I think I have to cover up that code, too, once it's on there.
Yeah, the little puppy.
And that is why we have puppies. All right. Now let me... Who's playing along with us? Who's having fun?
I will.
All right.
Yeah, the code's in the Discord.
Cool. Let me... So I get grumpy when I don't eat, so I was a little grumpy today.
You gotta remember to eat, dude.
I know. I just forget. I forget to eat because turns out you gotta do it every day.
I know, it just keeps coming back. It never ends.
Like, again? Alright. Let me make sure. Where is the microphone? Oh, I'm not plugged in. Let me plug this in. Oh, it sounds like R2-D2. Okay, here we go. And Aristotle, that's the phone I'm trying to use. I'm sure, like, the not eating didn't help with my, with my trying to order the phone. All right.
Yeah, get a little impatient.
I'm like, I just want the phone 2 months ago.
Looks... I opened it up to public, so we can fill it in.
Okay, cool. All right.
Never played before.
Okay.
Is it fun?
Yes. So,
excellent.
We're going to, for a crew, we're trying to get our spaceship ready to go. No, I think this is a different map. So we're a crew, we're on a planet, and one of us is an imposter.
Kill you.
Sabotaging and can kill. Yeah.
Yes.
Kill
me. But we don't know. And so we try not to talk in chat and say anything that would give it away.
Yeah.
Obviously.
You have to remain. Yes. There we go.
Oops. I feel like that's the one part I won't be good at.
It's okay.
It's okay. Just have fun. All right.
Yeah,
I think the code was given away, but that's okay. People can still join if they want.
It's okay. It's not that big a deal. Let's just
All right, guys. Now it's time to play. So it looks like we've got Laszlo. That's Wesley, I believe. And
yes, it is.
And we have Jen the Fierce, or just Fierce. All right. I'll grow the window. Okay. Here we go, guys. Who's ready?
Good luck. There's no, we don't know who the imposter is yet.
Oh.
When we start.
Oh, okay. Right now, you could just run around the screen. Shh. Don't tell who the imposter is.
Okay, now I'm.
All right.
Oh, this is the
map. So there's a list of tasks on the top left of your screen, and then there's a map that will show you how to get to all of them. All the exclamation points are your tasks. You have to go do them. And if the crew gets all the tasks done, then the crew wins. But if the imposter kills everyone, then they win.
All right. I like doing the tasks because they're kind of fun. They're like games inside the game.
Yeah, and you don't usually get killers, so you spend a lot of time doing that.
Yeah, I'm just like, menial task, I'll do it.
You're professional now.
Yeah.
All we're doing is... Wait, do we get paid? Top 10. Imposter.
Yep.
So I'm doing the wire task, and they were there pretending to do it.
That means when we have a meeting, you can vote for who you think the imposter is. Oh, I don't want to press that button. It's a big shiny red button.
It's a big shiny red candy-like button. What does it do? I don't know because you're not gonna touch it.
Oh, my beloved ice cream bar. I've loved you.
It's my ice cream bar. I've had it since I was a child. People are always trying to take it from me.
It sounds like we've got Ren on the phone here. Holy moly. All right.
Happy, happy, joy, joy.
Happy, happy, joy, joy. I should learn how to play that song. Let's see. All right. Happy, happy, joy, joy. Happy, happy, joy. I can't find any more. Oh, I gotta look at the map. Oh, I see.
I don't know this map, though.
Are there any sus characters out there? Suspicious characters?
I'm about to get killed, I think.
Oh, no.
What color are you?
Wait, no. Never mind.
What color are you, Wesley? What color are you?
Red. I'm not. I didn't get killed.
I find a dead body that's red. I will be report you.
Excellent, but I'm not dead.
I'm just going to connect these wires over here. Let me just make sure that these colors are lined up to the right. There we go.
Everything's fixed, guys. I've connected the wires. We're good to go. We're ready to launch.
Yeah, that was my job.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know.
You get the same job.
Oh, good.
Let's see. I don't want to step on anyone's toes here. Oh, how about this?
You're working on.
Is this hot lava? What is this?
Oh yeah, don't fall in the lava.
Oh no.
There's a lava pit.
The floor is lava. Oh, wait.
I think people are venting in office.
Is there someone in an office venting?
I'm an admin.
I got turned into a husk. Just a shell of what I used to be. And now I'm a ghost. This is pretty cool being a ghost, actually.
Now you can just do your task.
Yeah. Now I can... I can just press buttons and oh, here, wires again. I love wires.
Have you seen the little snowman outside? That's kind of fun.
Can you build a snowman?
No.
I have a question.
What are you guys doing on your tasks? I think we can...
I have one more.
I have one more.
How are you doing on your tasks, Wesley? Where are your tasks?
Let's see. There's. I'm in the bathroom, the laboratory now.
The bathroom?
Doing wire stuff.
Serious question. Do you want to build a snowman? That was my rendition of Frozen. There we go. Task completed. Look at me. Hey, Laszlo, you and me, we're just ghosts hanging out here. We don't mind being a ghost. Would you guys see a sequel to Beetlejuice?
You're both dead, so we can talk about it.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Octan also a
one. Well, no, look, I found Aristotle's body. What happened?
Thank you for recovering my body. Please make sure that I would like a green burial.
You asked me where I was.
I hope. Wait, I can. Let's see.
You can tattle. You can talk to each other. You have your own little ghost chat.
Ah. There's no, you can't.
Yay!
You can't use apostrophes.
Oh wait, do we get to vote?
No, you don't get to vote because you're dead. I killed you.
We died. But you know what? Being dead is way cooler. Janet was you the whole time. Jed, of course you found my body. You're the one who killed me.
Self-report.
Hey, look, I'm blue.
Yeah, I think someone took your color.
You can change your outfit.
How dare they steal my color?
You left the computer. You can hit customize and then change it.
I have a flower in my hair. That's pretty cool.
I have no idea what I'm doing yet. Oh, look, a quarter. It was Aristotle.
Yes, that's me.
I see a hairdresser.
I've got
a pink flower makes you look sus.
Well, you know, I'm trying to be counterintuitive. You're like, how could this guy ever hurt anybody? He's got a flower in his hair. But maybe I will kill everybody. Maybe I will be the imposter. The puppy is protecting our code. All right. I like that it sounds it's like Star Wars sounds, almost.
Yeah.
Now, when R2-D2 showed up in the last episode of The Mandalorian, that was a nice additional surprise, but it made perfect sense. I think that episode of The Mandalorian made so much sense. Everything...
Wait, I got... Okay, it's... Who's red? Yeah, I have a. They're faking it, or they're either AFK or faking a task.
Uh oh.
Let's see here.
I think they were faking.
I would like to find a nice task for to do. You know, I just live to do tasks. Let's see. I'm a task master. All right.
Fix lights.
Oh, I get, yeah, go fix those lights.
Tasks are you guys doing?
It's locked. I can't get in.
Still looking for a nice... Oh, I see one. Oh, nope. How do I get out of this room? Oh, there we go.
Oh, you have to push the... You have to turn it back on, the door.
I like to sing, I've been working on the railroad all the live long. Uh-oh. Watch out for the lava.
Oh, dead body reported, so. I'm gonna, I think it was Blackstone.
Okay.
Let's vote. Let's vote him out. It's not my turn to vote. Voting begins in 3, 2, 1. It's over. You're done. You're finished.
What task did Blackstone fake?
One.
Let's see if Blackstone...
You're rooting me!
Wasn't me. I voted Blackstone.
Uh-oh. Sorry, Blackstone. Tough break. He's like, I was framed! Uh-oh. Don't touch my flower.
I don't trust Blackstone.
All right. Look out.
Red is dead. Black is dead. Who dies next? Oh, wait. Get our tasks done quick so we can win.
I had to turn a key. That was fun.
I did that as well. It was the hardest task so far.
All right. I flipped a bunch of switches. It's my job to flip these switches every day.
You're looking mighty suspicious there.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Kill me.
Wait a second. Wait a minute. Who's that? Let's see. Blue is... Mm-hmm. Let's see.
So, it looks like it was either Octane or Fierce.
Uh-oh. Ah, Jen, it's...
It was you! I can't.
Jen, it's always you. I'm just going to try to...
When I started watching, it's like, it was always you. It's like, I guess... He never became the imposter. Never.
I think I've been the imposter once.
I'm not going to trust you.
I've got the Elmer Fudd hat.
I know not to trust.
Even when I'm not the imposter, I like to chase people.
In Vietnam.
It's like Maury. You are not the imposter.
You are the imposter.
All right. Ooh, I like
it's
that sound.
Let's vent Fierce already, okay?
All right.
So that's that simple. All we need to do is vent Fierce and we'll be safe.
Yep.
Help, help, help. I'm being stalked.
I'm gonna follow people and see who's sus. That'll be my...
Jared, this is a hard maze.
Or this one's good.
Okay. Not now, dude.
It sounds like Morse code.
Give me one moment, sorry. Someone was calling me on Discord. Okay, now I'm done.
Morse code. Oh. Where is a task? I would like...
Octane's behind me, I'm creeped out.
How old are you? Do you mind me asking?
Sure, I'm 12.
Okay.
Octane is awfully suspicious. They keep following me. And just don't seem to be doing any tasks.
That's suspicious.
I'm gonna go check everyone's health to see if anyone died. Where do you do that? Like med bay?
I'm not sure. I still don't know this map very well.
Oh, that's electrical.
I won!
Toddle,
you're you never suspected it was me the whole time. All right.
Third, I got disconnected.
Uh-oh.
Okay, I'm back. If I hadn't disconnected, I would have suspected you.
Look, I look delicious.
Are you able to change your name during the game, or...
You have to go back to lobby.
Ah, then never mind. It's gonna be gross.
It's so funny how we're sort of in this transitional period whether or not we should call him Baby Yoda or Grogu, but I think I've adopted Grogu.
Baby Yoda's an important part of the show.
Yeah.
And I don't know what they're gonna do with him with Luke. Like, are they gonna visit? Or are they gonna, I don't know, fast forward into the future? But they need to bring him back somehow.
Yeah, I don't know how they're going to do The Mandalorian without more Grogu, because...
Yeah, like, it's just not going to be as popular. Oh, but it's a cat. I have allergies.
They better come up with another cute type of thing.
They could put IG-88 there.
Yeah. There's one imposter. I feel like... Cara Dune had that little meerkat in a couple episodes ago.
They could bring Baby Groot into there.
They might as well, right? All right. This is a task like in the movie Die Hard with a vengeance. I've got to remove water from one thing and put it into another. Oh, wow. What'd you guys think of that trailer for Coming to America? I don't know. It seemed like it was the greatest hits from the first one.
But... It was very odd because I was trying to watch it on the computer and my phone at the same time and the Discord audio.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was a little hard to listen to both.
Yeah.
I'm in electrical, and I think I'm going to get killed by Shark Boy.
Uh-oh.
No. Ooh. Just, I know electrical is where you're always going to die. So. And
uh-oh.
They disappeared before the door opened.
I'm in an airlock.
There's no vent.
I got decontaminated. This is fun. I'm 3'6". That's backwards for me.
Come on, Shark Boy, stop faking your tasks.
Two
I believe Is This Will is also a tall fella.
How does this task work?
Which task are you doing?
What's the one with the weird sand waves?
Well, I don't know. I haven't done that one yet. Let me find it. See if I have that one.
Or maybe it wasn't a task. Maybe it was just some random thing I did.
All right, let's see.
Let me go to a medical bay. I think I'm going to check that.
Emergency meeting.
Is anyone dead?
I'm just going to vote for Jen because.
It's a pretty good vote, but.
That's a pretty safe bet.
Aristotle, can you check my text when you
have a sec? Sure thing, yeah. I have to. I have so many windows up.
I know.
Let's see.
Oh my god, no!
Yeah, Light Blue is so sus. Oh wait, that's me! I mean, no. Who else could be sus?
Oh man.
I'm not playing. It's totally, he's throwing shade at me, so it's gotta be, Laszlo.
I think
I got kicked again. Tell me when you guys are back in the waiting room. I need to do it.
What booted you?
Voting ends. Five. Four.
Oh, I haven't
been the imposter. You've turned everyone against me, though. I've really
We've poisoned the well. Let's see. Was
I'm going for a swim.
You were not the imposter. All right.
I was not. Now I'm a ghost.
No, nope, thank
I like
you.
Your cherry on your head. That's cute. Is it an apple or cherry?
It's a cherry.
It's your little strawberry sundae.
It's delicious.
Not berry. He cut off Rudolph's nose.
Oh, no. Uh-oh. Oh, man. I'm a ghost.
At least I can finish my tasks now.
Well, guys, I'm excited to watch the Aristotle Full Throttle Holiday Special with you guys tomorrow.
And, just make it better than the 1978 Star Wars special.
I think it's gonna. I was gonna say that should be easy, but that Star Wars holiday special is rough, and it's kind of delightful in lots of bad ways. Yeah. It won't be as long, I can promise you that.
Oh, I watched that thing. It's like an hour and a half long of garbage.
It is pretty bad. It is pretty awful. There's lyrics. Yeah. To the Star Wars song, literally Leia's like Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars. She wrote lyrics to it.
I started watching your reaction to it, but I haven't finished it yet.
Yeah.
Can someone tell me when the waiting room is open again?
This is going to be the last round for today because we have to wrap up the Aristotle Full Throttle show. But this has been. You've been a formidable opponent, Wesley. And we shall play this game further. We should play more of this game. Today I'm wrapping a little bit early because I do want to get that holiday special done for you. There is a lot more to edit. I'm going to be up all night.
I'm excited to see it.
It should be funny. Or it should be. That's the theory. That's the theory. That's the idea. The hope. But I'm just a ghost now.
Samesies.
All right. We shall play this game some more.
All right. Well, thanks for playing, Aristotle.
Yes.
Thanks for playing, Wesley.
Thank you guys for playing. I'm going to do the wrap up for the show. Wesley, you did excellently. Thank you for joining us.
I just got killed once by Jen the Fierce and then.
Did you survive the
other time? I joined the club. I've killed a lot of people.
Jen, you better watch out.
One day I'll just stalk in the vent until I kill everyone.
Yeah, that's a good idea. You want to hide. You know what I always say? How do you poach an egg? You hide in the bushes. All right, that's a hilarious joke that I made up.
You pretend to be an egg, and when you hear the other ones hatch, you leap out and kill the egg.
And that's what we want.
You don't want the egg to hatch. You want the egg.
You do. That is absolutely true. I totally agree. Thank you guys for joining me. Wesley, Jen, Zooted, Squidward. This is my first time seeing you online, but thank you for being here. Remember to subscribe, like, share. Hang out with us every day at 5 p.m., 5 to 6 Pacific Standard Time. It's a family fun time.
And it starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Time.
8 p.m. Eastern. That's right. Yeah. What is it Greenwich Mean Time? I don't even know. It's probably like 9 p.m.
It's 9:12 right now.
Actually, yeah, if it starts at 5 here and it's like 9 hours in the future, what is that? How many is that? I don't even know.
So it's 3 hours behind.
Yeah.
Or 3 hours ahead, so.
That's right.
So it's 8 when it begins.
So guys, if you're on the East Coast, it's 8 p.m. And if you're in the Europe, it's way early in the morning. That's where Tatiana is watching from. She usually gets up in the morning and watches the replay. So if you want to watch the replay, you're all invited to do so. What did we learn today? We learned that Verizon is a billion-dollar corporation that does not like to get more money. If you're trying to order a phone through them, good luck. What else did we learn today? Well, no man is an island. You can always go out and look for help. I've got help here from Jen the Fierce. I've got support from people like Wesley and viewers like Zooted Squidward, who was brand new, Raccoon Raiders. Appreciate you guys watching. I appreciate you guys hanging out every day. You know, that's something I'm learning right now, too. There's no man is an island. We learned that Die Hard is the best Christmas movie. Undefeated.
I agree. It's the best Christmas movie.
It's tough to beat. Let me go back to the clean feed here. It's a tough to beat Christmas movie. Except, I think I'm going to watch The Grinch once I finish the holiday special. We're getting close to wrapping it up. And I'm excited to show you, but you might just be like, oh, that was okay. But hopefully you guys can get the inside jokes and the references and the silliness. And hopefully it begets more videos that are silly, more videos that are narrative. I haven't made a video since April, I think, like an edited one. So it's actually getting me back into the habit of doing that. And now that I know how to do a shorthand version of it, maybe there'll be more. Maybe there'll be fun little things, like those little opening sketches, but, you know, actually written. Mostly improvised, but actually written. There's no logic to the new episode, but just go with it. So I'm Aristotle Full Throttle, your bro with the fro. Go with the fro. Remember, you can subscribe, like, share, qualify to win that PS5. Get a t-shirt, get a sweatshirt, get a coffee mug. But what you definitely need to do is call your mother, call your father. I'm Aristotle Full Throttle, your bro with the fro. And I'll see you tomorrow. The Aristotle Full Throttle Hollywood Christmas Special. Halloween, Hollywood, the Full Throttle Star Wars Christmas Special.